Today in the news, we got the results of an upgrade, some marketing material, and a huge upgrade to our computer's adrenal glands. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Before we start, let me give a shout out to Memory Express. They are the day one sponsors of Boot Sequence, and they're based here in Canada, where they offer a complete price beat guarantee. They're also a great destination for businesses, gamers, and for your everyday home tech needs. Do me a favor, go to their website and check out what they've got. Plus, Boxing Day deals are around the corner, so keep an eye out for them because their Black Friday deals were the bomb. Alright, let's start with the 1060. You probably remember that the 1060 had the GDDR5X treatment recently. Not only that, but the core chip was changed from a Pascal GP106 to a cut down version of the GP104, the same chip that is in the 1070 and above. Well, Tech PowerUp got their hands on a GDDR5X model, and they brought us the first review. Let's break it down. In terms of performance, the chip performs a little bit better than the regular 1060, and honestly, I'm being generous when I say a little bit. They tested a standard GTX 1060 versus the KFA2 1060 with GDDR5X. The KFA2 model was clocked a little bit higher, so I suspect that the difference lies there. In pretty much every game, the two cards were neck and neck with barely a single FPS difference. So what does this mean? Is GDDR5X a dud? Well, yes and no. GDDR5X has true potential in overclocking if you're into that. When they applied an OC to the card, the numbers shot up pretty significantly, giving this new memory an edge over the regular 1060 and beating out an RX 590. So why did I say it was a dud? Well, memory overclocking is left completely to the user. So if you're into that, that's great. But that also means that the results will vary from person to person. Would you buy a card if you had to overclock it? Personally, I used to overclock everything in my PC, but system stability always took a hit, so I tend not to do that anymore, except maybe for a light overclocking on the CPU. Plus, the 1060 is getting really old, and well, let's just jump into the next topic and see why it's not really worth it anymore. The topic is the RTX 2060. We just got some of the marketing material leaked by Andreas Schilling on Twitter. Nothing crazy, it's just the logo and some simple box prints, but we also get a confirmation of the 6GB of GDDR6 and that the new RTX card is likely to be unveiled around the second week of January or in about a month. That lines up with a CES 2019 launch. If you want to know more about the leaks on that GPU, click on the card right up here to see my roundup of all of the leaked specs. Then we have a curious little tidbit that popped up in the Steam Store beta. The launcher has a line of code that refers to Xbox. It says Xbox Pairwise ID. Most reports point towards it being a possible feature for Crossplay, and this would be a pretty massive deal. This would put Steam and Microsoft at the pinnacle of Crossplay. Honestly, I highly doubt that this will happen. I just wanted to touch on the subject so you guys would stay informed. Moving on, last week AMD released their next gen Radeon software called Adrenalin 2019, and oh boy does it come in packed with new features. The most impressive ones include raw performance increases in a lot of games. Not only do we get a raw FPS bump in some of the most popular games, but AMD has focused on some of the most popular titles to improve the fluidity of the gaming experience with frame time and responsiveness tweaks. Those games include Battlefield 5, Fortnite, Overwatch, Destiny 2, and a whole lot more. Another amazing feature added was Relive. While it used to be exclusive to streaming, Relive now allows you to stream your games to your phone, tablet, or Android TV device. Honestly, just this feature in particular makes me want to stick an RX 580 in my machine. The last one I want to touch on is Radeon Game Advisor. It monitors pretty much everything in game, average FPS, frame times, and all of these other performance metrics, and then it gives you some tips on how to improve those settings. Seriously, this is pretty much a godsend. I mean, in my case, I sometimes get this recurring stutter in game and it comes and goes and I just don't know why. If this Radeon overlay is able to tell me why, then it's definitely a plus for me. If you want to dive into the new software, watch the Hardware Connects video linked in the card up here where Eber will take you through it. Anyways, guys, that is pretty much it for the news. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Don't forget to drop a like down below. You can click right here to see the latest video and right here to subscribe. As usual, I want y'all to stay frosty and I'll see you guys on the next video. That's where I'd usually tap the table and then snap in the air, but I won't do that. I'm just kidding. Take care, guys.